And now on Animal Planet, Wilde's America. At least until we get the cease and desist order.
G'day mates, I'm Ian Wilde, and welcome to Wilde's America. Today, we're going to take you on a wonderful adventure to find an amazing creature, the how do you pronounce it again?
Chupacabra.
Chupacabra, right. Isn't that a two for $3 special at Taco Bell? Right. Anyway, the Chupacabra is a mysterious reptile-like creature who's been spotted all over the world. Can you believe it? And now it's been spotted right here in these fields yet again. So what is it? We really don't know. Rumors say it could have vampire-like teeth, spines along its back, a dog-like face, and maybe even bat-like wings. So that's what we're after on today's program. Our first stop is to go and visit a local witness who shot this amazing footage. And here we are at the farm of Farmer Dusty Rhodes, who shot this unbelievable footage. Dusty, tell us what you saw.
Well, I was laying in bed last night when all of a sudden I just hear this incredible caterwauling coming from my sheep pen. I mean, I'm hearing these sounds like, so I come and running down the stairs, and I was about to run out and see what's going on, and then I was like, wait, this could be dangerous. So I sent my wife out, and she come out and look, and then she come running back all scared and everything, and she says the three of our sheep was dead. D-E-D, dead. So, and she said that they have these, like, puncture wounds in their neck, like a vampire got them or something. You just got to get this how do you pronounce this thing again?
Chupacabra.
Chewbacca, that fuzzy thing from Star Wars? That's what's out here killing my sheep? I didn't know that. You got to get that thing out of here right now. Just get it. I got pictures. Let me show you.
Dusty, we already saw your stuff. Well, okay. That's what we'll be after in the next couple of days. And our goal is to try to catch this beast.
Where the heck is my camera thing?
After this, we'll have had all our traps set up and baited. And for bait, we heard that the Chupacabra uses a high protein and fat diet, and we thought, what better way to give it what it wants than a burger from a local fast food joint? We'll be back in the morning to check all our traps. I can't wait to see what this Chupacabra thing looks like in person. Don't look down.
Turn off the telly. Wait.
What? I was hungry.
It would seem that we're going to need to change our approach. Well, as we've seen today, it's not the easiest thing to catch these chupacabby thingies alive. So instead, we're going to try something different. Take its picture. They have these amazing cameras that when an animal walks in front, it breaks an infrared beam and the camera snaps a picture. But they're kind of expensive. So instead, we've duct taped the local kid to a tree and gave him a camcorder. He thinks he's getting an Xbox out of the deal.
Hey, Well, that solves the problem of explaining why there's no Xbox. Old Chubby Cabby was here, all right. And it looks like she's a force to be reckoned with. And she stole my camera!
After last night, we thought it might be a good idea to get our hands on a real camera. So we paid a visit to the local university to borrow one of theirs. They may be a little tough to deal with at first. But I'm sure they'll come around.
Kind of pictures we get in the morning. Of course, someone's going to have to stay with it overnight in case those goons from the university try to go back on our agreement.
Don't look at me.
Well, I'm not doing it. I've been out here all day in the freezing cold.
Fine. We'll do rock, paper, scissors.
Fine.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot!
Best two out of three. We've got a full roll of film taken here. And if any one of these is a good shot of old Chubby Cabby, this could be history in the making. Blasted kids!
That don't exactly look like the thing I remember seeing.
Of course, when history doesn't present itself, we'll take what we can get. Well, we try to get him to come to us, but sometimes you just gotta do things the old-fashioned way. We're gonna go after him. Preferably with as much gunplay as possible. Oh, come on. It's like you don't trust me or something. Well, at least I didn't do it in the middle of a gun safety lecture. Follow the trail. All we have to go on is a broken twig here, a claw mark there, and... Well, hello there. What's your name?
Megan.
Megan, eh? That's Australian for sexy.
I've got a black belt in jiu-jitsu.
Well, I've got a black belt in my pants.
But you're wearing a brown belt.
Well, thank you for noticing.
Uh-huh.
Funny. That line worked last week in Punxsutawney.
I would like to hold my hand.
How about we run a little bit?
How about cry a little bit?
I would like to hold my hand.
How about we run a little bit?
How about cry?
Where's my Xbox?
You deal with it.
What?
If there's one thing I've learned in my many years doing this job, it's that you can't trust Mother Nature. Old Chupacabra sure played hard to get, but maybe someday we'll be back to find out if there really is a strange and mythical creature here in these woods. This is Wilde's America. I'm Ian Wilde, and until next time, oh, crikey!